can draw the sun and the stars and the moon. I can draw anything. How about you?
Ready, set, draw!
Hi, I'm Tom Booth, and I'm the illustrator of Who Wins and Night at the Stadium. And today, I'm going to be drawing a character from Who Wins. Can you guess who it is? Ready, set, draw. So when I'm drawing a character, I like to actually use a lot of shapes and sometimes even letters to communicate, the character's face. So I'll usually start with the nose, and with that, you can actually see that it's kind of like the letter V. And then the next thing I'll do is I'll draw, an eyebrow. And for this story, we were drawing characters who had a little bit of aggressive qualities to them, but I didn't want to make them too aggressive. So I make the other eyebrow kind of like an arch. And that makes it a little bit more inquisitive. And so that way it's almost sort of like he's investigating. And then the next thing is the eye. So that's a sort of a straight line across and then kind of like a half circle. Just a quick line underneath, and that's sort of the bottom eyelid. And then you want to do the same thing on the other side. Two quick lines. Next thing you know, the face is starting to come together. And then you got to sort of outline the face. This character was an emotional guy. He had a lot of feelings. So the face is starting to come together, but I don't know, do you think you can guess who it is? Should I keep going? Okay, let's keep going and see if you can figure it out. So this character, one of the hints about who this is in the ear. And unlike all the other characters in the book, his ear is actually bandaged. And so we just do a quick bandage shape, and then we go back to the top of the head, and we continue what will be the hairline. So now normally I would draw a mouth here, but instead this character has facial hair, so we're gonna do a few quick lines, and we're gonna connect them back up, and all of a sudden he has a mustache. So we'll start here and bring a line up that connects to the chin, and then you'll have on the other side of that same line, it'll come up and it'll go right under where the ear should be. Any ideas? You got a guess? No? Okay, let's keep going. I'm gonna start adding something that's not in the book, but just specific to this drawing. So I'm gonna do four little, these are gonna be fingers. And then we're gonna add a thumb. This is gonna come all the way up and around. The head is kind of floating right now, and the neck as well, so we want to connect it to a body. So you start just at the top of the neck where the shoulder begins, and you can bring that line down. So you can just sort of do a half circle, just like that. And now it looks like from the shoulder to the arm, you can see where his arm is. So now we got to go to the other side, and we'll start right around the chin, and we're going to do a big U. We're gonna do another big U. And this is gonna be his other arm. And then this is where the end of his sleeve is. Speaking of which, we're gonna add a hand. We gotta do a top finger here. And then we're gonna add a thumb. It's almost like a C. If you look at it, it's like a reverse letter C. I'm just gonna add a couple more. He's starting to look familiar, maybe. We're gonna add a long black line, and I wonder what that is. That is actually a paintbrush. And you wanna show the bristles of the brush. And they're bent, which means that he's actually painting something as we're drawing him. I like to add some lines to sort of really show, that he's wearing a jacket. So now we've got, him pretty fleshed out. We don't really need to spend too much more time on him. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add another straight line here, and then that's gonna come across, and you're gonna do the same thing on the bottom, and then you're gonna connect this shape. And this is actually gonna be the canvas of his painting. And you can add a little frame, you can put little details on that. And the frame is starting to come together. And so now you have the outlines of your drawing, and that's really how I like to start. I like to start with a line drawing that shows, where I'll be filling in these shapes. And so once we've got the lines down, then we can start to use watercolor to start filling in the picture. And it's gonna go over our lines a little bit, but that's okay, because once it dries, you might see them a little bit more. You know, I'm using a pretty special brush. It actually has water inside it. So if I give it a little squeeze, you can see it lets water out. So I can fill in the rest of the face, for example, without having to add more water from my cup. But I do have a cup just in case. You can draw and draw and draw, but staying in the lines is still a little challenging sometimes, especially with watercolor, because it can be a little messy. But we're not gonna fill in the bottom of his face, remember, because that's where his beard is. So we're just gonna do the face here, and then we're gonna fill in these fingers, and then you can use some paint from the face again to fill in the other hand. All right, so that's the skin, you know, the face and the hands, and then we wanna give him some color in his hair, so we're gonna add some orange hair, and that is another hint at who this is, and that also applies to the beard and the mustache. It's best to work quickly with watercolor because the watercolor tends to dry as you're doing it, and if you really want kind of like an even balance of the color, then it's good to work quickly. And so now the face is together, and this guy had some pretty vivid blue eyes. That's blue's sort of a blue. Oh, you know what? I forgot the eyebrows. We gotta make sure that his eyebrows matches the rest of his hair. So let's go back to the orange real quick. We can add those. And then now we wanna add some color for his clothing. So we're gonna use some purple. You can stay within the lines, but he didn't always stay within the lines, so I think it's okay if you bend the rules a little bit. If you add more water, that means that there's less color. It's actually good to start with a lot of water and a little color because it's easier to then add more color later. You can decide how light you want, in this case, his clothes to be, and I want his jacket to be a little bit on the lighter side. And now we're gonna get to the painting. We're gonna add some more orange to do the frame. And I'm going with a lighter orange this time with a little bit of purple in there. That way it kind of looks like a brown almost, because I want it to look like it's wood. And then I'm just quickly gonna do the same drawing that I did before, but with paint this time. And now it's a self-portrait. And so this will just be an outline, but you can always add color later. And the outline of your portrait is done. So now you have him drawing a portrait of himself. And so, you know, you can add a little bit of color here. He loved color. He was a master of it, actually. And he was better than a lot of other artists, I think, at using color. And so in this case, he doesn't have a purple jacket, he has a blue one. And this is where you can kind of start to have fun. You can really kind of pick any colors you want because, you know, even though they look similar, this is a painting that he's doing of himself, and so he doesn't have to look exactly like what he looks like in the painting. He can just, as the artist, do whatever he wants. You know, we can use a bright green as the background. His paintings were very pleasant and happy, and they're considered some of the most beautiful paintings today, actually. So, we're adding the color in the face, and then it's starting to really kind of come together. Since he's a painter and he's painting, you gotta make sure that you're putting the paint that you're using on his palette, and that's really easy. That's just a matter of putting in little dots of color. You know, you can put as many or as few as you like. And then you can fill this in, but I think I'm just gonna leave it. I'm gonna add some color in his neck. Since it's watercolor, one of the exciting parts is that even though it looks dry, you can actually just add water really quickly and the paint comes alive again. So you can reuse some colors if it's thick enough. Not all the time, but sometimes. And then just a little bit more in the bandage. You gotta get the sleeve and the shirt. Can't forget the elbow, the most important part. Have you guessed who it is yet? This is Vincent van Gogh. He's one of the greatest painters of all time. And I actually had a hint here the entire time. He was sitting right next to me. He's right there. So be sure to pick up a copy of the book and learn about all the other historical figures in Who Wins. So that's my drawing. I'd love to see yours.